Lockheed Martin has revealed plans to enhance its most potent laser weapon to a new benchmark of 500 kilowatts. The initiative, known as High Energy Laser Scaling Initiative, HELSI, will involve upgrading the existing 300 kilowatt class laser that was delivered to the U.S. Department of Defense last year. Through the HELSI program, the laser's power level, efficiency, and size will be increased, along with improvements in beam quality. This upgrade is aimed at protecting stationary and partially stationary locations against threats such as rockets, artillery, mortars, unmanned aerial systems, and both rotary and fixed-wing threats. In this video, Defense Updates reports on Lockheed Martin's new 500-kilowatt laser weapon. Let's get started. The U.S. Army intends to deploy as many as 4 operational 300-kilowatt class indirect fire protection capability high-energy laser IFPC-HEL prototypes in tactical military vehicles by 2024. HELSI aims to enhance the laser's power output while maintaining an excellent beam, apart from increasing efficiency, size, and weight for continuous wave high-energy laser sources. Demonstrating this capability successfully will reduce the Department of Defense's, or DoD's, risk when acquiring and deploying high-powered laser weapon systems across all 6 branches of the military. Before Lockheed decided to scale up its highest-powered laser, the company had achieved several milestones in developing military-grade, high-performance, directed energy weapons. Earlier this year, the company's DIMOS, Directed Energy Interceptor for Maneuver Short-Range Air Defense System, laser weapon achieved first light in a laboratory demonstration, verifying its optical performance. Lockheed Martin's 50-kilowatt class DIMOS system is a ruggedized tactical laser weapon system that can be integrated into the Stryker combat vehicle to deliver robust directed energy capability to the U.S. Army's Challenging Maneuver Short-Range Air Defense (MSHORAD) mission. It also delivered the first laser weapon mounted on a tactical aircraft to the U.S. Air Force. Rick Cordero, Vice President of Mission Systems and Weapons at Lockheed Martin, said, OUSD R&E has invested in maturing high-energy lasers in support of America's warfighters. At the same time, Lockheed Martin has invested in our production infrastructure in anticipation of the Department of Defense's demand for laser weapons that have additional layers of protection with deep magazines, low cost per engagement, high speed of light delivery, and high precision response, reducing logistics requirements. He added, the 500-kilowatt laser will incorporate our successes from the 300-kilowatt system and lessons learned from legacy programs to prove further the capability to defend against a range of threats. Lockheed Martin said in a press release, Lockheed Martin is a proven weapon system integrator and has invested in demonstrating the maturity of its directed energy technology and increasing its production capacity to build laser weapon systems at scale. This OUSD R&E HELSI milestone exemplifies Lockheed Martin's commitment to develop enhanced technologies that provide speed and agility to joint all-domain operations. Lockheed Martin further stated, the 500-kilowatt class laser will be tactically configured, utilize Lockheed Martin's proven spectral beam combined architecture to support military platforms, and incorporate Department of Defense modular open system approach standards to ensure the system's interoperability and multi-mission integration. The U.S. Defense Department is particularly interested in directed energy systems, high-energy lasers, and high-power microwaves to protect military personnel and installations from aerial threats like short-range air defense and against drones, rockets, mortar, and artillery. Lasers have some crucial advantages, when compared to traditional kinetic means. The speed of light enables them to hit their targets almost instantaneously. Laser weapons also don't need to carry ammunition like traditional systems, and hence they'll be able to take out a much larger number of threats, constrained only by the power supply limit of the platform. They're also so much cheaper and could cost as little as $1 per shot. Another important aspect is that laser weapons could be used to defend against hypersonic weapons. An object is said to be hypersonic once they exceed speeds of Mach 5. That's 5 times the speed of sound. This is about 1,715 meters per second, or 3,836 miles per hour, or 6,174 kilometers per hour. Unlike subsonic and supersonic weapons, hypersonic weapons currently have no reliable counters, and laser could prove to be a solution. A 500 kilowatt laser will be effective against more types of targets and will be able to take them out at longer ranges. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.